We're Wise TV and we're here at the university's new Creativity Lab, sponsored by the Screen Industries Growth Network. Let's go have a look. This is one of the university's new VR headsets, and we're going to give it a try. So now we're here with Helen, who's the project manager for the Creativity Lab. So it's really cool. We've got a lot of stuff happening here. Can you tell us a little bit about the lab and why you wanted to implement it?
Okay, so the Creativity Lab is part of an overall project, which is the Screen Industries Growth Network. The university has such a strong remit with regards to digital creativity. So the library have implemented, or were basically learning this space at the moment for students, staff and people in industry, SMEs, across York and Humber to come and utilise the space.
Is there anything that goes into the technology you've picked? Is there any reason you want students to have access to this space, I guess?
I think there's lots of reasons as to why we've chosen particular kit in here. We've got everything from VR experience to podcasting to 3D scanning, and it's all tech, it's all kit that you can have fun with and be creative, but also students, I guess, can come in and use it within their academic work. So if you've got a particular project, say for example you're with the Department of Economics and you're thinking, how can I display, how can I show my work, but in a really creative and kind of different way.
So we're here with Sam, the Creatives Lab's creativity technologist. Yep. Hi.
Hello.
So tell us about some of the technology you've got on display today. There's lots of cool things around.
Yeah, so a creativity lab here in the library is a space where people can come and have a go and attend some workshops about some new and emerging bits of kit. So we've got things like VR headsets, 3D scanners, 360 cameras, and a range of other stuff for helping you to be sort of digitally creative and have a play and create things in a slightly new and interesting way.
And do you have a favourite application here, or something you think that students should go to first?
I've been doing a lot of teaching people how to make 3D models, so things for being able to create models for if you want to put them in your own game or for 3D printing.
What do you hope students can take away from the space? Like, what can they come and do?
So throughout the year, we're going to do a range of kit workshops, which will all be available to book on the University of York Skills Guides and the training pages on there. And we're going to do a range of kind of kit workshops where you can come and have a go with bits of kit that you've maybe never had a go with before, would like to learn a little bit more about, like introduction to VR and introduction to AR and 3D design and modelling and printing and things like that. So we're going to do a range of sessions throughout the year where you can come and give something new a go.
They even have a podcasting station where you can record your own podcast, radio shows, whatever you like.
The sound effects!
I don't think you can hear me, but right now I sound like a robot. It's very fun. Now we're at the Your Create Lab, where they do 3D printing and all of that sort of stuff. So we're gonna go in and talk to some people and see all the lovely prints. We're here with Siobhan at the Your Create 3D printer space. Hi.
Hiya.
Yeah. Tell us a bit about the space.
Brilliant, yeah. So this is a space which has got 3D printers, as you can see behind me. It's got some Ultimaker 3D printers and some Flashforge ones. And what they do is they print layers of plastic by making them very hot. And then you end up with a model that is printed made of lots of little layers of plastic. And this is going to be open for staff and students across the university to come along to. They have to attend an induction and then be able to come along and book the 3D printers and use them.
And how long would you say a typical print would take?
Yeah, so prints can take, depending on how big they are, and we've got different size 3D printers as well. So lots of ones take about an hour if they're quite small and not too fine detail, but other ones can take a few hours. We've had ones that have taken 10 hours that last overnight. In terms of how they work, the larger ones can be left, so they can be done for longer ones you leave overnight. The smaller printers, you have to stay in the room with them, but we will have seats and sofas and workspaces, so you can stay in here but do something else. You have to watch your print for hours.
But you can if you want to, of course. One last thing I learned was the plastic you use is largely quite sustainable. Do you want to talk about that?
Yes, so in these printers here, the plastic we use, which is called PLA, is actually made from recycled material. It's made from offcuts of potato starch used to making chips. So it's sort of byproducts of production to make other things.
Yeah, so you can come in, make some plastic figurines, and it's all sustainable and it's all good for the planet. And it's all a lot of fun. So there's quite a number of prints here that have been made already, all of these lovely little things. I really like this one. It's made out of a shiny thread, she said, and it took not long, I think half an hour to make. So, you know, you can make stuff like this at the lab if you want a little Pokemon. And then they also have these really cool little dinosaurs that can move. So if you want to make it, you know, raw or whatever, yeah, come on down, make your own dinosaur. Or you can, you know, make stuff that actually is good for class as well. But I think dinosaurs is the right way to go.